Thank you for taking the time to watch the GSI 18 tutorial. The GSI 18 is a single channel air conduction screening audiometer. It features a frequency range of 125 to 8,000 Hz and intensity range of up to 100 dBHL. The GSI 18 includes everything needed to perform pure tone screenings in any environment. The GSI 18 includes the audiometer, the over-the-ear headphones, and a custom-designed carrying case. A power cord is included, however, the GSI 18 may also operate using battery power when necessary. The battery compartment is located on the bottom of the instrument and holds 5 AA batteries. That gives enough power for about 10 hours of testing. Audiogram forms and a quick guide for basic audiometry and test interpretation are also included. Optional items include a patient response button and audio cups, which are circumoral enclosures that fit over the headphones to block out noise. Insert earphones are also available with the GSI 18 and can be added in addition to the headphones. The GSI 18 contains the calibration for both types of transducers for easy transition between styles. To set up the GSI 18 for testing, first plug the transducers into the back of the instrument. Make sure to plug the red right earphone connector into the jack labeled R for right. Plug the blue left earphone connector into the jack labeled L for the left ear. Then plug in the power cable or ensure that you have batteries inserted into the battery compartment located on the bottom of the device. Next, power on the instrument. Finally, make your signal selections and you are ready to test. The GSI 18 has 9 buttons and 2 dials. The 5 buttons in the blue work area are used to set up the signal and transducers for testing. These selections are usually done once at the beginning of the day. Signal modifications affect how the tone sounds when presented to the patient. The options are as follows. Steady tone, which is indicated by the button with a solid line. Pulsed tone, which is indicated by the button with the dashed line. And warble tone, which is indicated by the FM or frequency modulation button. The selected tone modification will be indicated on the LED screen of the GSI 18. The transducer selection will enable the proper calibration file for the selected transducer. The button with the picture of the insert phone will activate the insert earphone calibration, while the button with the picture of the headphones will activate the over-the-ear headphone calibration. The selected transducer will be indicated on the LED screen of the GSI 18. There is one right ear and one left ear transducer port on the back of the instrument, so be sure to verify on the LED screen which transducer has been selected. To the left of the LED screen, there is a button with a plus 10 on it. This button extends the decibel output by 10 dB for testing patients with severe hearing loss or patients that do not respond to the tone at the maximum intensity level. Under the LED screen, the test ear selection will be made by pressing the L button for the left ear and the R button for the right ear. The two dials will adjust the presentation frequency and the dBHL level. When the dBHL dial is turned to the right, the level of the tone will increase or get louder. When the frequency dial is turned, the test frequency will increase or decrease. Changes to frequency and intensity can be seen on the LED screen. Finally, the presentation button will present the pure tone stimulus to the selected ear and transducer when pressed. Before placing the transducers, it is recommended that you inform the patient what to expect from the evaluation. Explain that you're going to place the headphones over their ears and that they will hear a series of beeps or tones. instruct the patient to respond to the tones even if they are very soft or far away, by either raising their hand or pressing the patient response button. Once the patient understands the process, place the transducers over the patient's ears, making sure that the headphones are centered over the ears. Make sure the headphone labeled R is over the right ear, and the headphone labeled L is over the left ear. If adjustments are needed, remove the headphones so the distance between the headband and the earphones can be adjusted either up or down, depending on the patient. When the transducers are properly placed, testing can begin. For insert phones, examine the ear canals for obstruction or excessive cerumen. Place the black straw from the foam ear tip completely onto the sound tubes. Roll the foam tip into the smallest diameter possible. Pull up and out on the outer ear and insert the ear tip well into the ear canal. Make sure the right and left inserts are inserted into the correct ear. Allow the foam to expand and acoustically seal the ear canal. Discard the ear tips after a single use. The type of evaluation performed with the GSI 18 will vary depending on the facility. Be sure to follow the test guidelines of your facility to complete the evaluation. This may be one presentation at a single level for each frequency, or a threshold evaluation at multiple frequencies. Regardless of the test, you will need to record the results manually on the included audiogram pad or another form of manual recording. Select the test ear, frequency, and starting intensity level. For threshold testing, the goal is to find the lowest level in dB that the patient hears the tone 50% of the time. Press the presentation button to present the tone to the patient. If the patient does not hear or respond, increase the intensity by 10 dB and present again. Once the patient hears the tone, decrease the intensity by 10 and increase by 5 until the patient continuously responds. Mark the lowest level on the audiogram at the appropriate frequency, red circles for the right ear and blue X's for the left ear. Repeat for each frequency to be tested. The GSI 18 is not designated as a sterile device. Non-disposable parts of the system, including headphones and headphone cushions, which are in direct contact with the patient, should be disinfected between patients. This includes physically wiping down the components that come in contact with the patient by using a disinfectant approved by your facility. Use of a non-alcohol-based disinfectant is recommended. Non-alcohol-based products, which contain the active ingredient referred to as quaternary ammonia compound or a hydrogen peroxide-based cleaner, may be used. Both disinfectants are specifically designed to disinfect rubber, plastic, silicone, and acrylic products, which are commonly used in hearing evaluation instruments. This concludes the tutorial on the GSI 18. If additional questions arise, consult the user manual, your local equipment distributor, or contact GSI.